Good morning, class. We are in chapter number 9. Chapter number 9 and the adjective expression and identities. We have completed exercise number 9.1. We will do now exercise 9.2. Pairs of monomers. Okay, class. Your question number first is you have to find the product of the following pair of monomers. Okay, your first part is you will multiply these two terms, 4 multiply P multiply 7 multiply P. Okay, class? It will come. First, we will multiply the number. Okay, 4, 7, 28. P multiply P. Whenever the variable are multiplied, this comes in the square or a cube, okay, or its power 2, 3. You can see that both are same. You will write P 1 and P multiply P, it will come P square, okay. And you know that in the question it is given minus. It will come minus, okay. Now third part. All of them. Okay, class? Four theorem. One, P cube multiply P will come P to power 4 and minus, okay? Now fifth part. Fifth part is 4P comma 0. Okay, class? Solution. 4 multiply P multiply 0. 4 zeros are, as we know that whenever we multiply any number with 0, it will come 0 only, okay? And 0 multiply P, it will come 0 only, okay? This is a question number first. All parts are complete now. We will discuss portion number 2. Okay, class? With the following pairs of monomers as their length and breadth respectively. Okay, class? In question number 2, you have to find the area of rectangles with the following pair of monomers as their length and breadth. Length and breadth are given, you have to find the area of rectangle, okay? First is PQ. Okay, class? The first part is PQ, okay? You know that, student solution, what is area of rectangle? Area of rectangle. What is the formula of area of rectangle? Formula of area of rectangle is length into breadth. Okay, class? You can see that this is length, first one is length, you write P, multiply, and breadth is Q. What will be the answer? PQ. Area of rectangle is PQ. Okay, class? Second part is
length into breadth
There is only one n. N multiply n, it becomes n cube, n square, and n cube. Okay, this is the fifth part. Question number second, fifth part. Okay, class? Your question number second is complete now. Now we will discuss question number four. Okay? Question number 4. What is question number 4? Obtain the volume of boxes with the following length, breadth and height. Length, breadth and height respectively. Solution. First you have to write the formula of volume of rectangular box. Okay. Volume is equals to length into breadth into height. Okay, class. It is given that length is 5a, breadth is 3a square, and height is 7a, a to power 4. 5 3 is 15, 15 7 is 105. Okay. A multiply a cube multiply a to power 4, it will come a to power 7. Okay, class? This is your answer. When the variable are the same, its power is added. Okay? Now we will discuss third part, second part, you have to do yourself, okay? solution. Volume is equal to, not to write a formula first, okay? Length into breadth into height. Okay, class? Length is xy, breadth is 2x square y, and height is 2x y square. Okay, class? First, you multiply the number 2 to the 4. You can see that here is x square, here is x. You can add x, you can add the powers. It is 1, x power 1 is 1, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 1, 4. And y, 1 plus 1, 2, and 2 plus 2, 4. Okay, this is the answer. The volume of rectangular box is 4, x to power 4, y to power 4. Okay, class? Fourth part, you will do yourself, okay? Now, I will explain you fifth part, okay, class?
Okay, this is
16y cube. Okay. 2 4 ja 1024 by the power 6. Okay, this is the third part. Now we will discuss fifth part. Okay, fourth part you have to do yourself. Okay, class. Your exercise number 9.